Pharmacy Federation. So for today's presentation, today is a research category. So for today's presentation, I'm happy to introduce Dr. Thakur Gurjeet Singh, Associate Dean from Chitrakara University, Punjab. Ms. Rituraj Gaur, Principal Aishwarya College of Pharmacy, Rajasthan. And Dr. B. Wilson, Dayananda Sagar University, Bangalore. So we welcome you all. So over to Chavi to continue.
Good evening to all the evaluators, and thank you, Dr. Kalrajan, for starting the poster presentation for 7 days, and all the participants. So I would request all the participants and evaluators to switch on their camera when they are speaking, and a good internet connection connectivity. If you're not having a good internet connection, then you will be given a chance at the end.
429.
Ramesh sir, please change the screen to poster number 429. You can go ahead now. Please switch on your camera.
Am I audible? Okay. A very good evening to everyone, respected judges, and my dear co-participants. Today, I'm Rampali Teerda from PharmD 4th year from Sarojini Naidu Vanita Pharmacy Mahavidyalaya, Hyderabad. Today, I'm here to discuss a clinical study of proton pump inhibitors, evaluation and comparison of different dosage forms. So, first I'm going to talk regarding the title of the poster. What is the title? A clinical study of proton pump inhibitors. So what are the proton pump inhibitors? Evaluation and comparison of different dosage forms. So before going to the introduction of the poster presentation, first I would like to say that why I have chosen this topic. So whenever, as a PharmD student, whenever we go to the hospital visits, we see many of the case sheets. We see many of the treatment charts. The most common prescribed drug in every treatment chart is proton pump inhibitors. There are many, in every case, there is a pantoprazole or omeprazole or any other drug of proton pump inhibitors. So excess use of these also can cause a side effects. So this is the reason I have chosen this topic. Coming to the my poster presentation, it includes the introduction, materials and methods, results and discussion, conclusion and references. So coming to the introduction, so first, can I continue, sir? Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. So coming to the introduction, it's okay. So coming to the introduction, we know the mechanism of proton pump inhibitor, sir. So first of all, we know that what are the proton pumps in our body. So protons and potassium ATPases are the proton pumps of the body. So the mechanism action of proton pump inhibitors are they irreversibly bind to the proton pump so that they decrease the acid secretion in the body. So in that way, they decrease the acid production in the body, and these proton pump inhibitors are mostly useful in the GERD, peptic ulcers, and it helps in the decrease in the acid in the stomach, parietal cells of the stomach. So when we compare to the dosage form like IV and oral, the most effective is High dose proton pump inhibitors are more effective when compared to the low dose proton pump inhibitors. The most common side effects of proton pump inhibitors include nausea and vomiting. But over long term usage of proton pump inhibitors may lead to like serious side effects like anemia, kidney injuries, and fractures. So mostly anemia is due to iron deficiency anemia it may cause. So the mostly prescribed proton pump inhibitors are omeprazole, osimeprazole, pantoprazole, lisinoprazole, etc. So when we come to the materials and methods, so I have it is a observational and descriptive study. I have taken a case sheets of 26, a case reports of 26. In that the treatment chart which contains the proton pump inhibitors are collected. Among that, I have taken the proton pump inhibitors which were prescribed in oral form and which were prescribed in IV form. So IV form according to the age and gender, oral according to age, gender, comorbidities, and chief complaints. These are the inclusive criteria. When coming to exclusive criteria, pediatric and pregnant women. So when coming to the results and discussion, so among the 28 case reports, I have found that 58% are male and 42% are female prescribed with proton pump inhibitors. So among the proton pump inhibitors, 96% is prescribed with pantoprazole and other are 4%. So according to the age, according to the dosage form, intravenous proton pump inhibitors are 61% among 100% and 39% are with oral. According to the age, most prescribed to the older people when compared to that of the younger people. So severity of, because the older people, severity and prevalence of GERD is increased due to the age-related physiology, or it may due to the decrease in the lower esophageal sphincter activity. And there is no significant difference between the oral and intravenous form of proton pump inhibitors regarding underlying clinical condition. So these are the results and discussion. And coming to the conclusion, evaluation and comparison of different dosage forms of proton pump inhibitors under various conditions were studied and conclude that the most prescribed dosage form of PPIs are intravenous. There is no statistical difference between the oral and intravenous forms of PPI regarding underlying condition of the patient. So when sustained stable PPIs are required to promote clot stabilization in bleeding peptic ulcers, continuous infusion to be only form of administration to achieve required pH. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. I would request evaluators to proceed with the questions.
What is the overall conclusion of your study?
What are the major side effects in time linked with proton pump inhibitors?
Sir,
they are safe, whether they are not.
Sir, I could not hear it. The voice is breaking, sir.
Actually, like you. You have done a clinical studies on proton pump inhibitors.
As per American Association,
there are some, you can say that there are some drawbacks if they're prescribing this proton regularly to patients. So what are these basic drawbacks or these are major side effects of this proton in the case of cardiac patients?
You are not audible. You have switched off your mic.
Sorry for that.
No problem. Please go ahead with the answer.
Sir, I can't hear your voice, sir. I didn't get the question.
Just tell me about the side effects of the proton pump inhibitors in cardiac patients.
In cardiac patients, sir? Hello?
Yeah, in cardiac patients.
Okay, sir. Proton pump inhibitors, in case of cardiac patients, actually the in cardiac patients, the blood levels should be, iron and blood levels should be normal. And if proton pump inhibitors are given like a pantoprazole or something else, the iron deficiency of iron will be less. And also the... whenever the proton pump inhibitors are used in long-term cases, the weakness of the muscles can be occur, sir.
Thank you.
This study you conducted only on outpatients?
Sir, actually, these are the cases which we have collected during the hospital visit, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. This is not the outpatient case reports. Actually, we will collect the case reports and we'll write we will write these cases in our personal case sheet, sir. So these are the information, sir.
You said both oral and intravenous. So
yes, sir.
What about the product?
Dr. Wilson, a little bit louder. Because your voice is very low.
Okay. Am I audible now?
Yes,
sir.
you said you used both oral as well as parenteral formulations.
Yes, so, sir.
So what were the formulations? You say, for example, what are the tablets you studied, or what were the parenteral injections, the name of the products, I mean the trade names?
Sir, the generic names of these proton pump inhibitors are like pantoprazole, esomeprazole,
Yeah, correct only. I'm just asking some specific names.
Specific names means in different cases, different PPIs are prescribed, sir. So overall PPIs I have taken as a consideration.
Okay. So what is the overall conclusion of your study?
Overall conclusion of the study is there is no difference between the dosage forms of proton pump inhibitors, sir. So the condition of the patient or comorbidities or clinical condition of the patient does not, according to that, the dosage form is not prescribed. And those, but when compared to the oral and intravenous, intravenous are mostly prescribed because the effectiveness or immediate action of the intravenous is very high. So for purpose of immediate action, the intravenous drugs are prescribed, sir. Intravenous formulations are prescribed.
But when they prescribe tablets, generally they just prescribe tablet formulations only, no?
Yes, sir. But they prescribe in tablet formulation. But we have seen many of the cases like they have prescribed pantoprazole in IV form, 40 mg IV form. So in immediate case, like in bleeding cases, like bleeding peptic ulcers, in that cases they are prescribing intravenous formulations.
Rituraj ma'am, if you are able to speak, otherwise I will go ahead with your question. So this is the question on the behalf of Rituraj ma'am. What is the comparative efficacy of different PPI in reducing symptoms and endoscopic healing in patient with gastric ulcers?
Mostly the intravenous formulations are the mostly prescribed in gastric ulcers, bleeding gastric ulcers.
Now,
thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you so much.